Good morning. On behalf of all the Reyes family, I just want to extend my thank you for being here today as we celebrate the life of Robert Reyes. As we begin, we're going to invite the Lord to be here with us, because as we know, the Lord is where Robert is right now. So as you bow your heads and close your eyes, let's open up our hearts and minds. Father in heaven, on this tragic day, we come before you with broken hearts, tearful eyes, Lord Jesus, and a broken spirit. Lord, we ask that your Holy Spirit would fill us in our greatest time of need, as we are lost right now, questioning right now, Lord. We're searching. And Lord, we ask that your peace would be among us, that your angels would surround us, but most of all, God, that your very spirit would dwell among us. Be with us today, Lord Jesus, and let us look forward, God, to the day when we will see Robert again in your arms. And Lord, we thank you, God, for your blessings, and we thank you for your love, even in the hardest times of our life, times like today. But today, Lord Jesus, we choose joy, we choose peace, we choose love, because we know that's what Robert's heart was all about. So God, we ask your blessing upon us today, to shoulder the burden of grief, but to also let in happiness and joy, because Robert was such a light to all of us. In the name of Jesus, I pray. Amen.
Read Robert's eulogy written by his mother. Robert Andrew Reyes was born on November 16, 2008 in Fontana, California. He was the coolest kid you'd ever meet, sporting a mohawk and always wanting to color his hair. He supported my cosmetology profession 100%, always up to letting me practice on him. Robert was so kind, sweet, and loving. He had the biggest heart in the world. He was the baby brother to his brother Ryan and his sister Riley. He looked up to them and his older cousins with love and admiration. He was so excited to be the big cousin to the younger kids and was looking forward to being the one they would look up to. Robert loved his family so much and would do anything to protect those he loved. He had the best habit of saying, "I love you" and "thank you," and he didn't care who was around to hear it. Robert was also caring and knew from a young age that he wanted to help people when he was older, and decided he wanted to be a flight medic because he would be helping people, but in a cool way. Robert was only 15 years old, but he knew how to live. He made it a point to have the best time wherever he went, whether it was fishing with Papa at Redondo Beach Pier, family days at Knott's Berry Farm, or hanging out with his friends. He made it a point to have the best time. He was so funny, always laughing, always dancing and goofing around. I remember after moving to Idaho, we had our first big snow day. It was February 13th, 2021. We went on a family walk in the snow and kids were throwing snowballs at their dad. Out of nowhere, Larry turns around and football tackles Robert right into the snow. All Robert could do was laugh. He had a great laugh. We would rewatch the video of this day years later, and every time, Robert would laugh. He loved to go swimming and is the only kid I know who would wake up at 9 a.m. to do so. I remember when Robert called to let us know he got to drive a Hellcat. Most kids would keep it a secret from their parents, but not Robert. He also had a love for sports, basketball, football, and soccer. The lucky kid was treated to an L.A. Clippers basketball game, box seat at an L.A. Rams football game, and an LAFC soccer game. No doubt in my mind, it's because he was just a great person to have around. He made friends everywhere he went, and he was truly blessed and thankful for all he was given. When Robert was just 10 years old, he was given a school assignment to write where he thinks he would be when he's 30. And this is what he wrote, just at 10 years old. "When I am 30, I will be 5'11". I will wear Gucci clothing. I will look like Lionel Messi. I will have short hair and have a beard. I don't want to look old. I'll drive a Bugatti, Ferrari, AMG, Porsche, and Lambo. I will be a famous soccer player. I will have a lot of Gucci, money, cars, and a PS4 with Fortnite for my kids. I'll be married. There will be four people in my family who are my wife, son, daughter, and me. Certainly, my life at 30 will be lit and awesome. I can't wait to be rich in 30. I will make the world a better place by building houses for the homeless people and donate money for kids. I'll help families in need.
Thank you.
friends and family, members of the community, we're here to celebrate Robert's life. Within the healing embrace of God's love, we are gathered here to remember the life of Robert Bias and to entrust him to God's eternal care, knowing that God's good purpose for his people cannot be defeated by death. We are all children of God, and in faith that God has given to us, we turn to God now, asking for his comfort and his grace to be upon us, and to dwell in a special way upon Robert's family, and upon those who were privileged to love Robert during his brief stay on this earth. On behalf of the Reyes family, I would once again like to thank you all for coming. You are welcome here today, and we're grateful that you're here. What makes a meaningful life? What makes a proper and good legacy? Is it how long you live? Is it how much money you make? Is it whether or not you drive a Bugatti? Is it what you're able to accomplish? I don't believe it's any of those things. I believe that what makes life meaningful is not the time we spend here on earth, but the love we leave with those who love us. Robert Andrew Reyes, he lived a life of gratitude and love. So one of the memories that his grandmother shared with me is how every time he went to get food from the kitchen, which being a teenage boy was, I'm sure, quite a lot, he would always say, "Thank you, and I love you." He loved to dance. He loved to eat Blaze Pizza and Panda Express. He loved to hang out with his friends at Dave and Buster's. He loved his family, and he loved God. He knew what it meant to be cared for, because he had such a strong and loving family around him. He knew what it meant to be encouraged. He knew exactly how much his mother and his family loves him. There's that connection that exists. You can't see it, you can only feel it. A connection between a mother and a son. Father and a son, a brother and sister, from cousins, grandparents to grandson, uncles and aunts to nephew. Robert is part of something bigger than what he might even have understood. You see, Robert is part of a family. He knows each of your voices, and he waits for the day when he will be reunited with you. But Robert also knew something else. He knew the voice of his creator. Psalm 139 describes it this way. "You have searched me, Lord, and you know me. You know when I sit and when I rise. You perceive my thoughts from afar. You discern my going out and my lying down. You're familiar with all of my ways. Before a word is on my tongue, Lord, you know it completely. You hem me in behind and before, you lay your hand upon me. Such knowledge is too wonderful for me, too lofty for me to attain. Where can I go from your spirit? Where can I flee from your presence? If I go up to the heavens, you are there. If I make my bed in the depths, you are there. If I rise on the wings of the dawn, if I settle on the far side of the sea, even there your hand will guide me. Your right hand will hold me fast. If I say, surely the darkness will hide me and the light become night around me, even the darkness will not be dark to you. The night will shine like the day, for darkness is as light to you. For you created me in my inmost being. You knit me together in my mother's womb. I praise you because I am fearfully and wonderfully made. Your works are wonderful, and I know that full well. My frame was not hidden from you when I was made in the secret place, when I was woven together in the depths of the earth. Your eyes saw my unformed body. All the days ordained for me are written in your book before one of them came to be." You see, as much as we love Robert, as much as his family cares, there's even someone who loved him as well, maybe even more. God knew Robert in the womb. God loved him and watched him as he grew up to be a young man surrounded by his loving family. And now, out of everyone who has ever loved him, he is in the presence of God, who loves him still. Listen to these words from the Holy Bible, words written by the Apostle Paul as he considered the perils of human life and the sorrows that we must face to overcome it. And within these, the love of God as revealed through Christ Jesus, who died on the cross that we might live, and rose from the dead that we might never die. I consider that the sufferings of this present time are not worth comparing with the glory about to be revealed to us. We know that in everything that God works for the good of those who love him, who are called according to his purpose. What then shall we say to this? If God is for us, who can be against us? He who did not withhold his own son, but gave up for us all, will he not also give us all things within him? Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall tribulation, or distress, or persecution, or famine, or nakedness, or peril, or sword? No. In all these things we are more than conquerors through him who loved us. For I'm sure that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor things present, nor things to come, nor powers, nor height, nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus, our Lord. If you believe that, would you say amen with me? Nothing can separate us from the love of God. Knowing this in our sorrow today, we give thanks to God for the time in which Robert was among us and the inheritance that Robert, though wasn't as long as we had hoped, has received. We thank God, not of course for taking Robert from us, for it's not God's will that anyone should die, but rather for granting him a place with all the saints, a place where when our time is over, we may join him, knowing the fullness that which in our life here we have just begun to know. So today, our prayers are with Robert's family, his mother, his father, his brother, his sister, his grandparents, his aunts and uncles, his cousins, everyone that desperately and truly loves Robert. As I close today, I want to encourage you, as I believe Robert would have wanted right now, in three different ways. Don't take life for granted. Enjoy every day you have. Laugh every day and tell someone you love them every day. It would be Robert's hope that you would fill each day with joy, laughter, dancing, and hope. And it's that way that we truly live, that we truly honor Robert's life. It's by living like he did, full of hope for the future, full of joy for the moment. Don't take your loved ones for granted. Don't be afraid to say I love you and thank you. Hold the people who are close to us, and don't let precious days go by without reminding them how much you love them. Say it often, say it loud, and say it with words, and say it with actions. But don't take your loved ones for granted today. And thirdly, maybe most importantly, don't take God for granted. Don't take God for granted. God is here with you in good times and in bad times. He is here because he loves you more than you will ever know. And I think Robert would like to know the God, I would think Robert would like you to know the God whom he loved. Today, Robert is with him, having returned to his heavenly Father. But Robert would want only one thing today, and that is the people that he loved, to know the God he loved, so that one day in the future, his whole family would be reunited again under the care of our Creator. So, I must ask you the question today. Is your heart right Have you been taking God for granted? And if this answer is yes, then I can help you today. I can show you a path that leads to a relationship with God, peace, joy, and hope in times of trial. Out of respect for Robert, I can ask everybody just to bow their heads and close their eyes. If you would like to surrender your heart today to Jesus Christ and join the family of God, where death has no sting, I ask that you repeat after me. Lord, forgive me. I ask you into my heart. You are my Savior. You are my God. You are my Lord. I pray, Father, that I would live my life with the dignity of your word surrounding me. Help me to live in honor of Robert, loving my family, and loving you. Amen. As we continue our service today, remembering and calling upon the Lord for comfort, I invite us to reflect as we view a video, pictures of Robert, a slideshow of a young life that was filled with meaning to all of those whom he loved.
wishing you Godspeed. Glory, there will be mountains you won't move. Still, free.
Continue on without him. We look to you for guidance, for hope, and peace. And pray, Lord, that as we grow close to you, we grow close to Robert. Because that's where he is, he's with you. And so this morning, God, we dedicate ourselves to you, we dedicate ourselves to Robert's memory, Lord Jesus, that we too would live with joy, peace, dancing, and in happiness, God, giving you all praise and glory for the good things and the beautiful things of this world. We love you, Lord. In your holy name I pray. Amen. Everybody can just remain seated just for a moment. I'm going to ask Isaiah to come up and give us a few instructions about what we're going to do next.
Sweaters on, please rise and